Hello students, good morning. We have already started a topic differentiations. From this topic we have already done the basics rules for differentiations, product rule and quotient rule, implicit functions, logarithmic differentiations. In our previous lecture we have done parametric function. In continuation with this topic, today we will discuss chain rule and derivative of a function with respect to other functions. These are only the parts of the differentiation. Before starting today's topic, let's discuss first what is the chain rule there. Now, a chain rule is a formula to compute the derivative of composite function. Composite function means combination of two or more than two functions. Whenever we differentiate a function, it is already a combination of two or three functions there. But if particular chain rule solve the functions by chain rule there, then we have to apply the chain rule. Let us take one example that we have already done in the previous way of differentiation. Let's suppose fx is equal to log x cube plus 1 raised to power 2 there. Now, this statement is already the combination of two functions. One is log, one is another degree of a polynomial. Now, according to rule, first we will differentiate the term of log there. Log term means reciprocal of the another term. 1 upon x cube plus 1. Now, ddx of x cube plus 1 raised to power 2. 2 means now its turn of the degree there. Whenever we solve the degree, then the differentiation of the base there. These all are we have to differentiate by step by step. But if particular statement is there, solve the functions by using chain rule, then we have to apply the chain rule formula there. Otherwise, you can solve by any method. Now, what is chain rule? What is the working rule of the chain rule? First, we will separate the functions. According to chain rule, first we will separate the functions. We give them the another variable's name. Now, I am taking example where I have already taken the two functions there. Chain rule, when composition of two functions are there, first we will separate the functions. I denoted z is equal to first functions, then whatever the function is first there, it will be the another functions there. G u is equal to gx there. Now z is the statement of the first function and last variable is the x, so answer will be dz upon dx. We will find out these two differentiation, then we will multiply it and we will get the answer there. Now I am taking one example. That example is already the combination of two or three functions there. Differentiate sine e x cube with respect to x using chain rule. Now particular chain rule is there. Therefore we have to apply the chain rule formula. According to solution, first step is there. Let y is equal to sine e x raised to power 3. Now, sine e x raised to power 3. It means we are having three functions there. First of all, I am having function sine t ratio. Then e raised to power ratio. Then the variable is last one x cube there. Now, first of all, put e raised to power x raised to power 3 is equal to u full power with angle. X cube is equal to v. Then y is equal to sine u because its value is u. Differentiate, we want to change in u. Then differentiation with respect to u. Answer is dy upon du, ddu upon sine u. Same way, e raised to power v is the value of u, du upon dv. ddv e raised to power v. Then v is equal to x cube. Differentiate with respect to x, dv upon dx, ddx of x cube. When we solve ddx of x cube, answer is 3x square. When we solve e raised to power v differentiation, answer is e raised to power v there. And when we solve sine u differentiation, answer is cos u there. Now, I have to solve differentiation because variable is x there with respect to x. So, answer is dy upon dx there. We multiply these all terms there. Whatever differentiations by part we have already solved, dy upon dx is equal to dy upon du, du upon dv dv upon dx. Now by cancelling the term, dv or dv cancel, du or du cancel, you will get the value of dy upon dx there. Now put the value, cos u e raised to power v 3x square. Now u value is, what is the value of u here at starting? E x cube, put the value there. Then v value, what is the value of v here? X cube, then put value there. Then 3x square is as it is there. Now I am taking the another one subtopic there. Derivative of a function with respect to another function. Now, if we have to differentiate a function with respect to another function, already we have done that differentiation with respect to a variable. One variable are there. Now you are having one more functions there. Then how will you solve it? Differentiate sin square x with respect to e raised to power cos x. Now both are the functions there. We will suppose it for one variable for one function and the other variable for the other function. Now in this case, both are the changing in x with respect to x. It may be with another variables also there. So differentiate with respect to x for this case, differentiate with respect to x for this case. Whenever we solve sin square x, first is the term of degree there. So it will become 2 sin x and ddx of sin x. E raised to power cos x, ddx of cos x. Minus sin x ddx of cos x is minus sin x, e raised to power cos x is as it is there. But in chain rule, we multiply the both differentiation equations, but in derivative of a function with respect to another function, we will divide, same as in the parametric equation. We will divide these two differentiation. Now, the dy upon dx statement is 2 sin x cos x and minus sin x e raised to power cos x. We will get the answer. One function is y, so dy. Another function is z, so dz there. We have an answer in dy upon dz. Put the values there. Now, if division sign is there, when we change it into the multiply, the second term will be in the reciprocal form. Minus 1 upon minus sin x e raised to power cos x. Now cancel the term cos x, sin x, sin x. We will get an answer 2 cos x minus e raised to power cos x answer there. Now one more subtopic is there. Derivative of determinants. Now determinants, we have already done the determinants, 2 by 2 determinants, 3 by 3 determinants. I am taking one example where all variables are one, all statements are in the one variable only. So we have to differentiate with respect to x there. Now determinant is given, 3 by 3 determinants. Now according to this rule, you have to solve first the determinant. First you will find the determinant of the given value. At last, whatever answer you find out after determination, you will differentiate that functions. Clear, bache? Now, first of all, you will suppose fx is equal to this one, 0, whatever value is given to you. Then you will find out the determinant of this value. First of all, you will write down all elements of first row, 0, 5x, sin x, 0, 5x, sin x. In between, you will having one more negative sign there according to rule. Now, whenever you find out the values for 0, you will hide first column and first row 1 into cos x log x into 0. Cos x minus 0 is there. For minus 5x, minus 5x, you will hide second row, second column, first row. Then multiplication x cos x minus x square log x. Now, whenever you get this value, by solving this value, fx is equal to 0 minus 5x square cos x plus 5x cube log x minus x square sin x is there. Now you have to differentiate this function. After determination, whatever answer is there, you will differentiate that answer. Now f dash x will be there. After differentiations, we will write fx is equal to f dash x. Now x square cos x. X square cos x is the combination of two functions. Which formula you will apply here? You will apply here product formula. One function, second function. Same way x cube log x. Another two functions are there. In these all statements, you will apply the product formula. Then you will get the answer there. Now student, you will receive one YouTube link related to these topics. And your RoboMate module links are also be there. Go through that links. Do your homework. Your exercise 11.6. 11.7, 11.8. Three exercise all based on these three topics. Do your practice more and more. I hope you people will do. Thank you.